How's it going, everybody? Elephant Freaks here, and today I'd like to make a statement about NetherRealm Studios and all of the complaints that it had from the people that played their games, even including myself. So, if you know their mobile games, that's what people are complaining about. There's lots of issues going on in Injustice 1, Injustice 2, and Mortal Kombat mobile games that people just had so many complaints about, and they didn't even think that NetherRealm could even fix it. But apparently they did fix the hacker issue in Mortal Kombat mobile, but there's probably some other issues and probably other reasons why people don't really trust NetherRealm anymore. So, here are, my five reasons why I don't think a lot of people like NetherRealm Studios anymore. Of course, it's not just based on my opinion, it's based on other people's opinions on why they don't really like NetherRealm. So, developers, please don't be too mad while you're watching this. Please forgive us for all the hate that we had towards you. And fix all of your mistakes and everything. We will make it up to you, friends. Anyway, let's begin this video. Number 5. Applying packs that cost real money in Injustice 1 mobile. And also the removal of the 25% off gold booster pack in Injustice 1. So yeah, lots of people are probably complaining about Injustice Mobile now. Especially because now it's harder to get characters and, I don't know, even Shazam or some other people for the cheapest prices. Because the gold booster pack for 25% off is gone. And it's also going to be really hard to get all those other characters like Killing Joke Joker or Arkham Origins Batman and all that stuff. Because the Most Wanted pack costs real money. As well as the Sorcery Pack with Raven, Kondok, Black Adam, and Zatanna. And probably loads of other packs. I really hope the Arkham Pack is not included as a US dollar kind of pack. Because that's the only way to get Arkham Knight Batman in the game. There's no other way. There's no other way. You can either get a character, an Arkham character from the Arkham Pack. Which exclusively includes Arkham Knight Batman, or you can just never get him the entire game. Which would suck majorly. Ugh. No wonder lots of people are complaining about this. And I guess another part of the complaining that I forgot to mention there was how hard it is to get the metal characters in Injustice Mobile. Like, there's 6 metal characters in the game. I don't have one of them. And those metal characters are Metal the Merciless, Metal the Batman Who Laughs, Batman Ninja Robin, Batman Ninja Catwoman, New 52 Black Adam, and even the nefarious New 52 Shazam! Like, I have none of those characters. Even though I do play a lot of Phantom Zone, and yes, I did open a Nith Metal Ultimate pack, but guess who I got instead? Gold Blackest Night Doomsday. Yeah. So yeah, the chances to get the Nith Metal characters are very bad, which is probably another reason why I think people don't really like NetherRealm Studios' decisions. And yeah, the packs cost real money, which also sucks. On to the next one. Alright, number 4 comes to us from Mortal Kombat Mobile's hacker situation, before they updated it to 2.0. So, yeah, there's no hackers in Mortal Kombat Mobile anymore, but before, there were a lot of them, which included, like, the Bill HOMKX, or Jon Snow HOMKX, or, I don't know, Bruce Wayne 6. There's been a lot of immortal hackers on the game if you had, like, Elite 7 level 50 characters. Like, it was getting really annoying. Like, it was mostly obvious when you watched a couple of Star and Skies videos. I'll, have a link to his channel in the description for this part. But, yeah, The hackers that he faced were insane. Mostly the hackers that took no damage, and the ones with the hacked talent trees. It was kind of dumb how NetherRealm Studios removed characters that had, or removed players that had too much coins and too much souls, but they never get rid of the legit hackers themselves. That's bullcrap. That is absolute bullcrap. Why didn't NetherRealm Studios do it in the first place before they finally decided to do it in Update 2.0? I'm just saying, guys. They should have done it in the first place. But they're all gone, and there's nothing we can do about this situation anymore. Hackers are all gone from Mortal Kombat Mobile. Alright, next issue. Number 3. The conversion of gold characters that were also challenges into diamond characters in Mortal Kombat Update 2.0. Yeah, it's gonna be so much harder to get those characters now. Because apparently, now they're all in diamond packs, which cost loads of souls. And guess what? You've only got 2% chance to get each individual character, which sucks. Same also goes for the MK11 pack if you try to get MK11 Sub-Zero or Scorpion. But most of the packs are all diamond teams as well, like Circle of Shadows team with Dark Empress Katana, Dark Emperor Liu Kang, Tournament Quan Chi, the Ronin team with Ronin Kenshi, Ronin Takeda, and Ronin Katana, the Cold War team with Cold War Scorpion, Cold War Sub-Zero, and Cold War Sonya, the Dia de los Muertos team with Dia de los Muertos Iron Black, Dia de los Muertos Katana, and Dia de los Muertos Jade. And of course, it's all Day of the Dead, but as I said in the last video, I like calling it Dia de los Muertos because it's a bit more believable. Now, assassin characters, of course, they also appear in diamond packs as well. Assassin Katana and Assassin Jade. Apparently, when I got my Assassin Katana, I did not open the Assassin pack. Because apparently I had a 10% chance to get Katana in another pack, which was kind of an anniversary one. Oh man, 1 in 10% chance to get it. No wait, 1 in 10 chance, which was 10%, to get Assassin Katana. Compared to the actual Diamond Assassin pack, where you can only get her as a 3% chance. Ugh. Glad I opened the luckier pack. Oh, that would have been a huge whap on my life if I did not open that pack and I had my Thunder God Raiden and Flaming Fist Liu Kang ready in that video. Like, wow, man. Things would have definitely changed if I didn't have Assassin Katana. Oh, man. I still don't have Assassin Jade, but oh well, you just gotta believe. Now, those other teams that they changed into Diamond Packs were the Revenant team with Revenant Kalau, Revenant Sub-Zero, and Revenant Jax. Sub-Zero and Jax's Revenants were both exclusive to the NetherRealm pack, and now they're exclusive to the Diamond Revenant pack, which kinda sucks, cause you don't have a chance to get all three of them like you do when you open a NetherRealm pack when Warlock Quan Chi is also in it. That also sucks. But at least it also costs less souls as well, because the NetherRealm pack costed 850 souls until it was finally removed from the game. And now probably the most expensive thing in the game is only like a couple diamond packs now. There's nothing more expensive than that anymore. Now, Strike Force team is also a diamond team, which also means there's a Strike Force diamond pack as well, with Funk Cassie Cage, Undead Hunter Johnny Cage, and Spec Ops Scorpion. And I think the last team that we have is the Nightmare team, with Nightmare Freddy Krueger, Relentless Jason Voorhees, and Pretty Lady Leatherface. Yep, the Diamond Nightmare team. And, pretty insanely, I have almost every single Diamond character. I have Ronin Kenshi from the Ronin team. Cold War's, the whole entire Cold War set with Scorpion, Sub-Zero, and Sonya. The whole Dia de los Muertos set with Katana, Jade, and Aaron Black. Almost the whole Assassin set. I've only got Katana, as I just said. And Strike Force team, I've only got Undead Hunter, Johnny Cage. Let's see, I do have the whole Circle of Shadows team. I have Dark Empress Katana, Dark Emperor Liu Kang, and Tournament Quan Chi. And I also have Revenant and Kung Lao from the Revenant team, and Nightmare Freddy Krueger from the Nightmare team. So out of all those characters, I'm only missing a few diamonds, which really isn't that bad for a complaint. You just have to get a lot of souls, kid. You just gotta get a lot of souls and be very, very lucky. Hopefully these people will get loads of souls in the future and be able to get the diamonds that they want to, guaranteed, for free. Although it's never gonna happen. Okay, next complaint. Number two, yet another complaint for Injustice 1 mobile players. The battles after you do the Arkham Origins Batman boss and the bonus level and everything. So the boss battles against Blackest Night Superman and Batman Ninja Catwoman are most likely going to be impossible to get to. Like, for me, it's kind of impossible because I don't have a Elite X level 60 character, which is basically what you're supposed to have in order to beat it. I think all the characters I have are mostly Elite 7 level 50. Like, they don't have very much of a chance to get past them, which really sucks. Like, why did they add the breakthrough system when only one character can be breakthroughed at a time? That's just stupid. And you can't even break through Arkham Origins Deadshot, Suicide Squad Deadshot, or even Arkham Asylum Killer Croc, which is incredibly annoying. Because, you know, there's a lot of people that want to have a fully maxed out Deadshot, a fully maxed out Killer Croc, and all that stuff. Well, other than hacking the game, I don't really see any point to get them through the breakthrough, because it's not even going to allow them a guaranteed extra copy, which is incredibly stupid. Hopefully, NetherRealm Studios fixes that issue. Other than that, I'm not very satisfied with Deadshots and Killer Crocs not being able to get to Elite 10 level 60 like all other characters. I'm tired of this bullcrap that you're throwing at us, NetherRealm. Like, fix it if you're gonna fix it, as I said in one of my videos. You really need to fix this. There's lots of Deadshot and Killer Croc fans out there. Don't just leave them disappointed, because they're gonna want them fully maxed out and all that crap. Help them as much as you can. Even if people have to hack their way, just understand that they're trying to completely max out their Killer Croc and their Deadshot. Know in your heart how they really feel about their characters. Especially me, because I really want to have a fully maxed out Suicide Squad Deadshot. Which I know is never going to happen, because he can only be at Elite 7 level 50, unlike any other character. Same with Arkham Origins Deadshot or Arkham Asylum Killer Croc. Okay, the last and final complaint against NetherRealm Studios for this video is... Alright, and the number one most complained video or complaint against NetherRealm Studios in general is... the addition of Darkseid and Brainiac into Injustice 2 Mobile. That is the number one complaint. I just don't want to put up with it. But yeah, I'd say that's my number one complaint. Apparently, it's a bullcrap chance to even get a legendary hero, unless you open like 50 chests or something, and then you'll finally get one. I just don't like how they handle the legendary heroes in the game. how they have to be so freaking rare compared to gold and silver that they're near impossible to get. Like, seriously, NetherRealm? Ugh. Especially Brainiac, because you had to keep grinding loads of power gems for his shards in his ultimate chest, which unfortunately is not in the game right now, but it was last week ago. It was last week. Yeah. People are most likely never gonna get Brainiac in their life. There's like way too many gems that they would spend, and they'd only get like 40 or 60 Brainiac shards from opening one of those chests with just 500. That's super annoying. Or 5,000 even, if they're trying to open like 10 at a time, which would be a double whammy of a cash grab. I feel like unless you have enough power gems, there is a snowball's chance in hell that you're ever gonna get these characters. It's just impossible. It's just impossible to get these characters unless you're really lucky. I feel like that's the only way to really get the characters. There you have it, guys. All five complaints that I'm sure loads of people would probably spit fires on NetherRealm Studios over. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'm very sorry, NetherRealm, if I made you guys mad, but understand that people themselves are mad at what you did. So, yeah, hopefully all these issues will be resolved, and everything will be fixed, and the world will be a much better place. So, hope everybody can enjoy this video and be happy once again. Elephant, slice that like button, subscribe today to join the Elephant Ninja Clan, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, everybody!